Linux is powerful, but with that power comes the potential for mistakes. And some of these errors are actually really subtle. So I'm going to clear things up with some easy to understand demos and cover some of the 5 most common commands that are used incorrectly by basically everyone. Maybe not you. Let's find out. So we'll kick off with chmod, which is obviously to set permissions. Now, one of the biggest pitfalls with chmod is setting these permissions too broadly, like using 777 on a file like I've done in a terminal here. Now, this gives read, write, and execute permissions to everyone, which can actually be a huge security risk. Instead, you've got to really think about who you're giving permissions to. Maybe instead you'd actually want to change this. We could go over here and we could change it to 700. Now, by doing this, we're limiting access to the file owner only. This still allows you full control over the script without opening it up to other users. Now remember, the first digit sets permissions for the owner, second for the group, and the third for others. And understanding how to use permissions properly is so important. So the chmod command is easy to use, but it's also easy to use inappropriately, especially when it comes to setting permissions too broadly. Now let's talk about the rsync command for synchronizing files and directories. Now, the thing with rsync that people may often get wrong is that the trailing slash on the source directory needs to be there, otherwise it might lead to unexpected results. Without this trailing slash, rsync will copy the entire directory into the destination instead of just its contents. So what you see I have here, I've got the my data going to backup, but if I put a slash at the end, the contents of my data are going to arrive in backup rather than the actual folder of my data. Now, this seems really simple and subtle, but by adding that trailing slash, we ensure that the contents are copied rather than creating an unnecessary MyData subdirectory. We can also add some flags. We can come over here and we could add the A and V flag. And with these, what are we going to do? Well, the A flag preserves file permissions and timestamps, which is really helpful. And the V makes it verbose, so you can see what's being copied on your screen. And depending on your preferences and how massive the copy is going to be, having that verbose output can be really helpful to go back over if anything goes wrong or is unexpected. Now let's talk about the find command for searching for files. Super simple command to use, but it's also potentially a tricky one because many users might forget to quote the name argument in find. And that would cause the shell to expand, in this case, the wildcard.txt before find runs, leading to pretty unexpected results or errors if there's no matching file. So simply all I have to do is add quotes around my argument and everything will run as expected. I'm now telling find to look for files ending in .txt. Without the quotes, it will interpret this differently. If there's no match, your search is not going to work correctly. So it's a small, subtle difference, but knowing to add those quotes is very important. Now let's talk about the grep command, and we're going to look at recursive search. And when it comes to recursive search, we've got a lowercase and a capital R option. Now, of course, when you're using grep to search recursively, people often miss the difference between these two options. Lowercase r, capital R, what's the difference? Well, while they both search directories recursively, lowercase r will skip symbolic links, while uppercase R will include them. So if you're using grep with an uppercase R, this ensures that your search includes all files and all symlinks, providing a more thorough search. If you only want to search regular files, of course, lowercase r is fine. But knowing the difference is the key between saving and losing and missing out on key results. So knowing this subtle difference might seem like, oh, what's the point? They're both recursive. Well, if you want to be very thorough and you want to catch symlinks, what are you going to use? You've got to use your uppercase R. So small difference, subtle difference, but it's an easy error to make. And I think it's really important for people to understand that. Now let's talk about the ps command for viewing processes. Now the plain ps command shows you only your current shell's active processes, which can mislead you if you're troubleshooting system-wide. And maybe newer users and a lot of users don't realize that they need additional options for a complete view. And what do? Well, we use the AUX or the AUX add-on there. And this lists all active processes across the system because the A flags includes processes from all users. U gives detailed information to X should processes not attach to a terminal. This is hugely useful for identifying high resource processes or background services. So when it comes to using PS, yes, it's helpful on its own, but adding this AUX or AUX is going to make it incredibly powerful and much more helpful. And that's it. Those are the 5 commands that are really easy to get wrong, and a lot of people do get them wrong. But they're even easier to get right once you know those small details. And mastering these tips, I think, can really help you avoid some common pitfalls and work even more effectively in Linux when you're at the command line. So I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I can't wait to see you in the next one.